Ladies and gentlemen, good morning to the very first session, debate session of day three, the last day here. And I see the clock is already ticking, so we might as well make very good use of our time. I see as people are still piling in here in the room. I welcome you this morning to a session titled, in a very unambitious manner, the European Union and the World. So this is really the all-encompassing panel that we'll be dealing with, because you might have missed with all the focus on Donald Trump these days, and we had a spectacular panel, of course, you know, yesterday. You might have missed that the European continent is also going through some headaches and troubles these days, and to talk about that, about the European Union, where the continent is headed, where the union is headed, I'm very pleased to an esteemed panel here today. Each of them will get 5 minutes for opening statements, and then we'll engage in a very lively Q&A with your participation. Of course, starting with the gentleman to my left, who, of course, is familiar to many of you, has held many important positions, including as the Assistant Secretary of State for European Affairs at the State Department. He also served as ambassador to Germany during a very critical time, namely from 1985 to 1989, and currently he's the managing director of McLarty Associates, based in Washington, D.C. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Richard Burr.
Richard, as somebody who's American, obviously, but as I said, you served in Germany as ambassador, worked on the EU quite a bit. We're very curious to hear about your opening statements, to hear your take right now on the current state of the European Union.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going